You're listening to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast with your host, T. Pendel. Enjoy.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, T. Pendel. Welcome back to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast. I am your host, and I am here with, let the ladies go first.
Shy.
Tiana.
And
Mike.
We in here, man. Thank y'all for coming. Everything good?
We good.
On a scale from 1 to 10, how you feeling today or right now in this moment?
Good,
I'll
say a 10.
A 10?
Yeah.
Don't be lying on the pod. Yeah. You a 10?
A 10 is crazy.
You took a shot, y'all. Talking about, I feel good.
Two shots.
Where you at? T, how you feeling?
I'm a 9.
A 9?
Yeah, I'm tired. I woke up at 7 a.m.
A 9 is
so good. A 9 good. Yeah, that's real good.
On a Saturday.
Where you at?
All right, I'll be the only one that's honest. Mm-hmm. I'm at a cool 7.
I'm a 7, too, bro.
Seven,
I'm a 7. Eight. I'm on a 7 machine right now.
I got a 7, though.
I got up. I came here and set up first. Then I went to the beach and shot public interviews. And then I showered now, and we're here.
How was that? Was it packed over there?
Yeah, it was a little litty.
Are they on a curfew for real?
Not on Fort Lauderdale.
Oh.
I ain't messing with Miami. Y'all can have Miami.
Yeah.
Muy dangerante. Risky business. High risk, low reward in Miami. So let's get right into it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Is it cheating if?
I'm going to say yes to everything.
Damn.
Facts.
If the nigga sneezes, he cheated.
Get a bullet.
You tell someone while you're in a relationship. You're in a relationship, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you tell someone, if I was single, I would sleep with you. Is that considered cheating if your man or woman did that?
Yes. Because you're thinking about it.
Why I'm just would thinking you be... about it. I'm just thinking about
no,
it.
No, but why would... But if you have a chance, then you're going to act on it, right? If you're single. So if right. relationship ends, you're going to act on it. So say for example, if you send that as a text while you're in a relationship to somebody else.
Yep,
say,
yep,
if
yep,
I
yep.
was single, then, you know, I would sleep with you.
Mm.
That's cheating. That's premeditated.
Have you ever thought to yourself, like, damn, if I ain't had no man, I would sleep with him? I'm asking.
That's not
have you
question.
Ever thought that?
That was not the question.
Have you ever thought that?
No.
Now you lying. Now we gonna start the pod all
no,
lying.
No, for real.
You ain't never said, if I was single, he could get it.
No, because I'm not single. Like, if I'm in a relationship, I'm not single. I'm not gonna be thinking about.
What?
That's a yes. All right. So, do you think that's cheating?
If we're in a relationship,
yeah.
and you tell somebody if I was single, I would sleep with you.
Yeah,
is that cheating? Yeah.
And you found out about it.
Yeah, because one, you're entertaining that person.
Mm-hmm.
You're giving them, you know, hope.
A chance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I don't like
chance.
That. I don't like that.
When I all become right. single. We gonna,
yeah.
You know,
it's also it's almost like you got them on standby.
Yeah, like,
see, the thought, if the thought was there and you didn't express that, that's one thing. But mm-hmm.
yeah,
you expressed it. It's kind of like flirting, like you shooting your shot.
Basically,
I don't like that.
Basically, wait on me. Wait till this. If this fucks up,
you know, you next.
Hey.
You next.
Hey. I'm gonna hit you up.
Be patient, baby.
I don't think girls do that though. I think that's men. Y'all do that.
Do what?
Oh, if I ain't have my girl, you know,
I got a lot of DMs.
That's
be
just
like
a compliment.
If I was,
yeah.
That's just like a compliment.
Yeah. I don't know. Women do that shit. Women be like, if I wasn't married, if I was, I still, women will do that.
Older, I have heard like older
women,
say,
probably.
Yeah. But if I wasn't married,
right. You wouldn't. You only knew what
marriage
I did.
Marriage changes a person, you know.
Shit.
So
damn, Sheila.
Not Sheila.
Miss Cheryl be written.
Miss Cheryl,
how old? Never mind.
Chill out. see what I'm saying? What do you think? Do you think that's considered cheating?
Shit. Listen, if my your girl yeah. if I overheard my girl
thank
telling
you.
Another man that,
mm-hmm.
then my girl's single.
Thank you.
Yeah. Period. Oh, it's a wrap.
That's see? Facts, yep.
I like him. He not
so
just
what about you?
One-sided.
What if you heard your girl saying that? Or you saw a text message or a DM or something like that?
Yeah, I would be upset. I wouldn't consider it cheating, but I feel like it was like a boundary that was crossed and it was some disrespectful. Like it was I find it disrespectful, but not cheating.
But would you do it?
I don't know. Like, so it's almost like I would feel like, damn. It would be a good feeling because you already know your significant other is lusting for someone else.
Mm-hmm.
That shit. So now mentally in an aspect that even if y'all are being intimate together, that shit in the back of your head, like you think, I'm thinking about it, I'm like, damn, she wish she would like another nigga was knocking her down. Like, you know what I mean? So I'm like, damn,
yeah, that's crazy.
I feel like it's harder for men to get, you know, wrap their head around that. But I feel like women, we deal with that all the time. Y'all lust over women all the time.
Yeah, true. That's true. Like women can, y'all, it's accessible. It's easy for y'all to, if y'all want it, y'all can get it. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it is hard, like, for real. You know what I'm saying?
So I feel like what T said, it's kind of different because like, you could think about it. It's cool, whatever, imagine, whatever, whatever. But if you act on it,
don't speak it out. Don't be saying it out loud.
Keep it to yourself. Yeah.
Like, talk to your head. Like, all right. So is it considered cheating if your partner listens to a playlist someone else made for them? You know what I'm saying?
Made for them?
Yeah, like I made this playlist for you. And this girl made a playlist for your man. Like your girl, another dude made a playlist for your girl, you know what I'm saying? And them hits on there.
I don't know.
The greatest.
And he listening to it.
It's not cheating, but I mean, it's like.
It's not cheating, but I mean, I feel like it's silly.
That's like.
Nah, why is my queen getting the ring?
Yeah. First of all, play this shit. Let me see what the hell he thinks is going to be going on.
He said, my queen. I like that.
He said, no.
He got honcho on this shit. Oh, no. I don't like that.
Dedicate a song to my queen or host a song to my queen.
That's crazy.
And then what if it's some like crazy ass songs too? Like,
okay, what if it's like sexual?
Knocking the boots. Knocking the boots.
He's like boyfriend number two.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
But no, I don't consider that.
LA Confidential on that bit.
Like if she was just like,
shit would hit.
Yo, that's crazy.
Like if she was like, oh, my work husband gave me this.
Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy. Wow, that's crazy.
Somebody actually dedicated that song to me like back in the day.
Don't be trying to put back in the day on it.
No, I swear to God.
Ain't been out that long.
No, I swear
to God. All right, back, way back.
Swear to God, back in the day.
All right, no, I don't think it's cheating, but I think it's disrespect, especially if you listen to it. You know what I'm saying? Because while you're listening to the songs, you got to think, You're listening more in depth to the lyrics. Mm-hmm. You're like, damn, why did this person pick this song? Oh, right. This is like you think about the time. It's more than just a playlist.
I guess it depends on what leads into them sending that playlist. Like if it's just a random person that DM like, DM like, yo, I made you this playlist. Mm. If it was random, then you listen to it, you'd be like, oh, whatever. But if it was like a whole text conversation, y'all flirting. Yeah. Ooh, I made you. I dedicated it.
Oh, even if she get excited
you.
About the playlist, why you? Why you giggly about the playlist?
God, dude? Like,
how are you cool enough to know what my girl likes?
Right. Exactly.
Oh, this song made me think about
this
you.
Song reminds you.
So it depends.
Of us.
Yeah, I think it depends.
I mean,
not
I,
of us.
I was
that's
still.
Crazy.
Us is nuts.
I would still that's go crazy. Off, but that's not cheating to me. But I would go
that's
off.
That's not like, oh, I'm about to leave you because somebody sent you a playlist and said, this is
yeah,
for
I'm just
going to
be like, let me get her number.
Let me see. Put the,
this
put the
is silly.
On. Yeah. Call her. Call Miss Playlist.
Grow up.
Hit her up. Is it cheating if? And this is more for the ladies because guys really don't be on no shit like this. But if you had too much to drink, I'm going to ask you this. If your girl had too much to drink and she kissed her girl best friend. Like, they, you know what I'm saying? They had like a little, couple little pets, little makeout section. Like, you know how girls
so
always do.
If your girl kissed her
if your girl
friend,
kissed her girl.
Who's female.
Yeah.
Okay.
Would you consider that cheating?
Nah.
Okay.
Nah.
I've heard some men say like, some men will get mad about that.
Yeah, I know a lot of guys get mad about that. I know most guys get mad about that. Girl probably left him and went to like a lesbian relationship.
Not oh, wow.
They that's scarred them. Yeah, so they got that.
Yeah, okay.
They got that trauma built in. They think
PTSD.
Like, right, oh, no sleepovers, wow. No none of that. Like,
not no sleepovers.
Well, I know like in certain situations, the guy will get mad because he wasn't a part of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that too. Mm. That's
right.
That's,
oh, so you kissing girls now?
You
when
kiss
I asked you to kiss a girl, you ain't with that. That's what I'm like. So let me get it right. Like,
yeah,
maybe trying to figure it out, you know. But I feel like I don't think it's cheating. I feel like it can be innocent because girls do like that little play kissy face shit, and then a lip might touch like right here or some shit, or like they do the little tongue shit and shit happens.
What if it goes further?
That's what I'm saying. Well, if the shit goes, and some women don't think like, oh, it's another girl. Like,
but you might think like, damn, am I that trash that you flip sides?
Right.
Like,
you know, now you start looking like I ain't never think like that. I just be like.
It's fun.
Can I come too?
You know what I'm saying?
Like, you know what I mean? Can I be in there? Like, type shit. Like, so It does. It matters how, like, if it's passion behind it or how often it happens or if it's like, you know what I'm saying?
Or even who it is.
Right.
You know, I think.
Right. Because I even growing up, I've witnessed like women, like I've had women be like fond of me and they'd be like, my homegirl just got a relationship. Mm-hmm. Like, I think she would like you. Like, and that girl likes me. So like, I already know what they're trying to set up. Yeah, they're trying to set
set up
the
a 2v1
up. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm that's like, crazy. I'm like, yo, that's crazy. Let me see what she look like. Pull out the Instagram. Crazy, you know what I mean? But it happens like that. So I don't know. I feel like it matters if your girl has like a pass of liking women as well, or if it's just, or if that girl likes women. Because sometimes girls be trying to convert. They be trying to do their little, get your girl sauced up. Yeah, and you know. Mm-hmm. And then now, a titty in her mouth. How did y'all get here?
Shit escalated quick.
Yeah, so I just want to tell you about something that happened last night, but I don't want you to be mad. I'm like,
yo.
Oh, shit, now I'm sweating right now. I'm
why
sweating.
Why you know the line?
I just don't want you to overreact.
Oh, has that line been said to you before?
Yes. Yo. I'm sweating instantly. I'm not going to lie. I'm like, here we go.
That been me before.
At least he's being honest, though. He says be honest.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, that happened a couple times, you know.
She said it happened to me before I heard that, and then like, I ain't gonna lie, it happened to me a couple times. This shit had no shit happens, but
the liquor. See, that's why you ain't drinking now.
Yeah, dude, that's how shit happened. And I don't wanna hear like, I was drunk. I'm not trying to hear that shit. Like, I've been around you drunk. I tried to get you to do some things drunk.
You
said no. But now the liquor got you.
And when I was in around.
It's like when women be drunk around their men, it's a whole different kind of drunk. Because you still got to pee, you know?
Break down the drunken. I want to hear, this is good for me. I never knew it was the difference. So what's the difference being drunk around your man and drunk around the girls?
Because I can have a blast drunk around my man with my man. But mm-hmm. at the same time, usually it's a lot of other girls, you know. So you still got to peep what's going on because sometimes they think you too drunk.
Right.
And then they be trying to throw
and
a little
trying
funny,
a little, you know, grab with a face.
Hey, pull you over talking about, I don't think I ain't see that little girl try to touch you. Oh, which that shit do we have? I'm like,
I was
damn.
Over there talking in the corner for
long. What's so funny?
What's so funny?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, but drunk with the girls, how's that?
You're just having fun. Mm-hmm. You're just
yeah,
having
like
fun.
When he's,
you don't
you
have
know,
to worry about anything much, really.
Yeah, when he at home, I'm having fun with the girls.
Oh, okay. All right. It's the exact opposite for guys. Like, when I'm drunk around the homies, these guys are on their own. Like, I have no, like, they're grown men. Like, I'm like, damn, a bit Phil. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, such and such. I'm having a time. I'm not helping them up. I'm laughing.
Damn.
We're cracking jokes.
You're not
I'm trying to get
up.
My phone out to film
no,
it. But when you out with your girl and you drunk, you security.
Yeah. You
like,
gotta,
I got to keep her safe. Nobody bumping into her. Like, I'm just let me see if the wave move and a fight break out in here. Because you know when a fight break out, it should just move different in the party.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So I'm like, hey, back up. Like, it's like, I'm having fun, but not too much fun.
True.
Yeah.
You know what
true.
I'm saying? Like, because shit could hit the fan. But when I went to guys, oh, this shit like Project X. What's that?
Hangover.
Hangover.
Have you ever had like a hangover experience like that? Like a movie?
That's a bit extreme if you have. He don't want to say that.
I'm trying to figure out.
With the sunglasses.
All right, let's run this story time, bro. I don't want to suck up too much time. Pause. So my friends were in Mexico. They were there the day before me.
Shit.
They were in Mexico. They were there the day before me. Group of six guys. You know, mm-hmm. so I'm the last one to arrive.
Mm-hmm.
I show up, two people missing from the night before.
Oh, Lord.
Right? Okay. So, boom, they're like, yo, we ain't find such and such. We can't find such and such.
In
I'm
Mexico,
like,
that's not a good place.
Let's go on. Like, what? Let's talk about what happened last night. How did they get here? So, we start talking about it. We start mentioning it. We start searching, showing pictures around the whole, what's
he
it called?
Lost
the
us.
Whole,
Resort.
They like, no, we haven't seen him. Woo-de-woo. I'm like, yo, what happened last night? They give me the breakdown. Oh, we went to this club. And so ultimately, one of the guys pop up out of nowhere. He's like, yo, everybody's looking for you. And he's like, yo, T, they got me last night. I'm like, yo, who got you last night? This guy was tipping everybody at the club, like fives, like acting like he was Big Willie.
Mm-hmm.
He goes to leave. They put him in the cab, the right cab.
Oh, Lord.
You know, the police pull the cab over. The police hold him at gunpoint and rob him.
Yeah.
They take everything. ID, money, passport.
They take
everything from him. Put him back in the cab and take him to the resort. I knew the cab driver was. I'm like, yo, the cab driver was in on it. He's like, why you say that? He dropped you off and you ain't pay him. He, like, you had no money. The police robbed you. He just dropped you off. Yeah. Like, everybody's in on
it. They be scheming out there.
Yeah.
They be scheming. So that's how we found him. We still missing the other guy. The guy that got robbed, he speaks Spanish as well. We go down there to file the police claim about the police that robbed him. As soon as we wait to talk to the police, another guy comes out. That's the other guy that's been missing.
Oh. They got his ass too.
He took some drugs, like some little party drugs, got missing and woke up in somebody's apartment with no shirt and just shorts on that didn't belong to him, and he didn't have his wristband to the resort.
That's all right.
So that's $100. You need that wristband just to get onto the resort. He ain't had no money. He ain't had no nothing. He ain't had nothing. So I had to foot the bill of that. I'm just getting here. I'm like, yo, I ain't getting no drink yet. Like, it's all inclusive. Like, so boom, we get him right.
Yo.
He doing his report. So now this is fun and fine that everybody's there. But now y'all have really no way to get back home.
Right.
Have no passport, no IDs. That's they got to go to like the what's it called?
The
embassy.
Yeah.
You got to go to the embassy and shit, but it's closed because it's the weekend, so you got to wait till Monday. So that shit popped off. And then what made it worse, that same day I got in, one of my homeboys went on like a booze cruise. Mm-hmm. And he got off the cruise. You're lit. You're drinking all you can drink on this cruise. He sees, it's not many black guys there. He sees another black guy that's kind of like muscular, stealing the attention. Just typical male drinking energy. He's like, oh, you think you're faster than me? They line up and race on the sand. But it's sand and you've been drinking. He falls during the race forward and breaks his wrist.
Yo, what?
Bro, his shit was so, it looked like it was a monster on top of his wrist. He had to fly home
this
early.
This too much.
Yeah. This is your first day.
Hey.
This is too much. I'm not so going back to that.
That's how the first day popped off.
Yo, he had no shirt on and somebody else's clothes.
Yeah. That shit, that's how it popped off.
So they never got their passports back.
One of them had like a little finesse to get back in because of his job. He had a really good job, like a government job. So he finessed the guy back. The other guy had to stay 2 extra days and just foot the bill and figure it out. And we just shot him some cash and some money. You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. And then we went four-wheeling. And then a guy fell off the bike and damaged the bike.
Oh, this is just not a good trip.
Mm-mm. And we had to pay $160. So they wouldn't let us leave until like they got the damage. And it wasn't worth no $160. But we out there in the middle of nowhere. What we going to do, guys?
What did you do?
Mm-hmm. We got to give them their money. Yep. So that was the hangover type of trip. Shit was terrible, too, man.
My people don't play.
Yeah, we met some married ladies out there though. I was like, "Oh, what do you guys do?" They tell me, "I'm like, oh, we're just married." I'm like, love y'all married.
Oh, I have a question.
I got an answer.
It's for everybody. Is it cheating? No. Well, it's cheating. Would you still marry your significant other if they fucks with somebody else on their bachelorette trip or bachelor trip?
What you mean? Like,
yeah, define.
Like, what's F else. With
if
somebody
they,
else?
If
give me the extent of it.
They cheated.
If they fuck a stripper or their bachelor party.
Or a prostitute. You know how niggas be doing in the DR in Colombia.
You see how she still made us the victim? You know how niggas be doing. Like, we're still, some kind of way, we still got faulted just now. So would I still go through with the marriage if...
Right.
If, give me, rephrase that. Break that down. Go ahead.
Okay. Let's say you're getting married.
Mm-hmm.
You have your bachelor party.
Mm-hmm.
Your girl have her bachelorette party. Y'all in different states. You know, she with her friends. You with your friends. Shit pop off.
She sleep with somebody. You sleep with somebody.
Your fiance.
Hold on. How did I sleep with somebody? No, I thought she just slept with somebody. I slept with somebody too?
The question was, if y'all cheat before y'all get married, meaning if y'all cheat during your
on the bachelor trip or weekend,
I'm probably not. It's a wrap.
No,
but if both of y'all did, doesn't it kind of cancel it out?
Yeah, imagine if
like y'all are in this relationship, y'all get engaged, right? Mm-hmm. And nobody cheats to anybody's knowledge. Mm-hmm. Nobody cheats the whole time up until getting married, and it's your bachelor weekend or bachelorette weekend, and you decide to sleep with somebody. Are you gonna marry them?
Nah, like no. If she just got like a lap dance or whatever, but if she got homies nuts in her guts, I'm good. I can't do it.
Nuts slapping that butthole.
Okay. Another question for the men.
Hold on. Let me say that. Just to answer that, I'm up out of there.
Good.
And then
it's a no
just
for me,
for
dog.
Like. God damn, like, you know, but, and then I don't want nobody to think your question is off the wall, but that has happened.
No, but
I've seen shit like that happen.
A lot of people cheat.
And the bachelorette women snitch. Like, yo, she did this on the, like, the, like, you know, cause you take the bachelorette, they're part of both families.
Yeah.
No, like, I've seen
people snitch and be like, yo, she did this shit.
I've been on trips where it'd be the bachelorettes going wild.
Going wild.
Pussy and yeah, all.
Right. Going getting crazy. The meat smacked on their forehead. I've seen it all.
What?
Yeah.
I'm the stripper. Ew, please don't give me male strippers when I get married.
No, no, no.
Give me the women.
I'm telling y'all right now.
Women, we don't like male strippers.
The married women and the married women crew. They just be, because a lot of times the married women, the bachelorettes, half of them are already married. And the bachelorettes, half of them are, but they
be wild.
They doing the most, the wild.
Like, but it's usually their friends that's like pushing it.
Putting gas it up, yeah.
They be freaky.
Telling you shit like, you don't know what I would do to you. I'm like, yes. Nasty old lady.
Little freaky ass girl.
Okay, next question.
Go ahead.
This for y'all, because I mean, I meant for it to be this way the first time, but I just, for the sake of it, I said both of y'all. What if y'all cheat? Are y'all gonna tell your wife to be if you cheat on that trip?
Are you gonna walk into that church if you're gonna marry at a church? If you're gonna walk into that church and say, "Babe, I got something to tell you that happened." Because
remember,
last
his
night.
Last answer,
and
was,
you're not even supposed to see the bride before you walk down the aisle. So how does this work? What if you text her and she don't show up at the
aisle? So you're telling me basically the bachelor party is the night before the wedding, like some people do.
Yeah.
So listen,
or the weekend before.
If you're cheating at the bachelor party or the night before the wedding, you might not need to do this. Like, you might need to wrap it up or figure, unless y'all already, the relationship set up like that, is open or woody woo. But even if that's the case, you got a busy day tomorrow, bro. Like, you know what I mean? So I couldn't see myself in that, but shit happens. You put me in it.
The whole weekend.
The whole weekend.
It's not just the day before, it's the weekend.
Yeah. Most likely, if something popped off like that, I would say something, because I'd rather hear from me than somebody else.
Yeah.
You know, so you were honest, nigga.
Yeah. If something hit the fan, I'm like, listen, I got to talk to you about something. Like, hey, listen. Boom. You know what I mean?
Hey,
I knocked her down. Yeah. I make it seem real simple. I knocked her down.
What if, though, like, she's been faithful for you. Mm-hmm. Let's say y'all been together 6-7 years. Mm-hmm. She's been faithful. I'm talking about not even a sign of her cheating. Like, always respectful.
Right.
But you found out, like, she told you, you know, the week before on the bachelorette trip that happened. But you know that's not in her character.
Yeah.
Does that mean any different?
Yeah, it still take a toll.
Count for nothing.
It do mean,
for me, it's like a mental thing.
I ain't gonna cap. Yeah, I'm not about to be thinking about. Yeah, we might have to postpone this shit. Hey, we gotta back this shit up, man. We gotta back it up.
Thinking about
yeah.
You just
we gotta take a breather.
Somebody the last week. I can't see
y'all telling the truth.
We gotta postpone it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Why you don't see nobody telling the truth?
I love telling
the truth. That's been my biggest problem.
Like, this is the girl, though, that you love. Though. Yeah. Like, I'm just saying, like, you got to
But
really
the day before
out.
The wedding, you gonna risk it and tell the truth? The day before the wedding? You already paid for everything.
The day before.
In the real world, she's going to tell you after.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not speaking about the women.
Man, hey, be mine married a week or two. Boy, you want to believe what happened before we got married, boy?
Yeah, that'd probably be like,
yeah, they had me
out there. At the 5-year anniversary, man. And she joking with her girls and be like, remember? And you be like, what?
What if she just told you like two weeks after? You can't even get a note. She's like, yeah, she was crazy. Yeah. And bent over all wild. Like,
yo,
it hurt. I didn't even like it. It hurt. What?
Stop.
Yeah, I feel like, I'm out of there. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I'm out of there.
Yeah.
I'm out of there regardless. And
I would be.
And as far as my honesty, like,
I ain't doing it.
I'll chop it up. I'll talk. But if you start asking me shit and I'm like, and you act like you want that truth and like you ready for the truth, let's let the good times roll. Let's talk about the truth.
I thought you wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
Huh?
Huh?
What, no, I didn't hear you for real.
Yeah, I knew. What'd she say? Huh? I thought you wouldn't do it. She said,
"Nah, I wouldn't do it." But I'm telling the truth though. If you start asking me about, I'm letting it roll up. Yeah.
Well, that's good.
So be careful what you ask me about, because some people can't handle, you know what I mean, the truth like that. So let's get into a lighter subject. We all remember the great days pre-pandemic, like, you know what I'm saying, even in our middle school days or high school days when the movie theater was it. I feel like every Friday, that's where we was at.
Every
like,
Friday,
we
hit the movie every theater. Saturday.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If you were from South Florida, like if you and Brian, we hitting the Oasis, the Sawgrass Mall, that's where we at. You know what I'm saying? We just chilling. Even if you ain't got your money and your funds right, you know, buy a ticket, slide the ticket back, open the side door. We got to get in here, guys. You know what I'm saying?
Open the side door is crazy.
Yeah.
That was everywhere, because I'm not from Broward, but like back home, it was the same.
You
like,
sneaking in the theater.
In high school.
Somebody opened the side door. Somebody was working at the movie theater.
Opening
in high school.
Imagine
my grown age.
I probably snuck in a time or two in college too, though.
That was like, that was elementary, seventh, eighth grade, you know.
Or you finish a movie and then you go into another one.
Yeah.
I know that. That was my bag.
My parents put me onto that.
So what was the what was the most lit movie that you went to that was like super packed, super crazy?
I feel like it was like, for me, it was like Scream. Remember when, like, Scream was coming out? Like, I Know What You Did Last Summer type of shit?
Yeah, but
like, when them scary movies were coming out, that was huge. Not Scream. Is that the parody? Is Scream the parody?
You might be a scary little bit older than me.
No, Scary Movie's a joint. So, yeah, okay. I think Scream was, like, the litest time for me. So, and then if you want to get into, like, a regular movie, like, that was, like, a box office hit type of shit, it was more like a Jurassic Park sci-fi type of shit.
What you got? Well, for me, it was For You Got Served.
Oh my God.
No, get for real. No, dead ass.
But that shit was so...
It was so packed, though. It was. I'm talking about how many people was there. It was so packed. There were people sitting on the floor watching the movie.
I don't remember.
I thought you was going to say Fast and Furious or something, because they were showing up for that shit, too.
No, I'm just remembering, like, from what I remember walking into and seeing how many people was there for a movie as a child, you know?
The Dark Knight with the Joker.
Ooh. The Batman. All the Batman shits was packed. Yeah. It was in there. Ooh.
The Dark Knight, though, went crazy.
All them shits. Transformers was lit too, though.
Yeah. Transformers was another one.
And the movies was like 2.5. Them shits was long movies, boy. I'm like, don't go here. I'm like, I got hit this joint at 7 if I don't get tired of here. Because now the seats recline and lean back and whoop de whoop.
The seats now do too much.
They do too, but I'm like,
I saw that. There's a movie theater, and I think in Miami where you go and the shit's shaking and shit.
I don't need all that shit. I'm in the arcade.
You're getting a
whole
massage in the movie theater.
Like, yo, relax. Why are you shaking me right now? Like, I just want to watch the movie, eat my popcorn.
I like the ones that serve food.
How do y'all feel about like scary movies now?
They don't hit like they used to.
Nah, not at all.
Nah.
I feel like they're a little bit too demonic for me these days.
Yeah, it'd be little demon shits.
Like, I'd be like, dang. It's like basically like The Exorcist every time it's a scary movie. Like,
I don't watch scary movies.
I miss shit like, you know what was cool? Like, The Ring.
Yeah.
That little motherfucker. Yeah. Or Paranormal.
Paranormal Activity.
I stopped sleeping with the door. I said, oh, this door got to get closed for the next month.
You know what one was crazy for me? Because it didn't show nothing, kind of like Paranormal, was the Blair Witch Project.
That shit was, it was weird.
It threw me off, though. Yeah. It was creepy.
No, you know what fucked me up? What was the one that shit happened before, like shit would happen on some freak shit? Like, that fucked me up my whole childhood.
What like shit, what, that's how you gonna it give start us
with
shit
F.
What happened?
It started with F. Like they was driving and the shit would fall off on like the weirdest on the highway.
When like oh they would see it before it
exactly.
happened.
Exactly.
You don't know.
Yeah, it was like four of them hoes they came out with.
She was in a tanning bed.
Come on, guys.
Or the
put
roller coaster one.
I know what you're talking about, but we gotta get this name.
Yes. It starts with that.
They're in the comment section commenting shit right now.
Fuck.
It was basically like. Like, they saw it happen, and then they were on the airplane, and they seen it crash, and they're like, stop the plane! And then
but
they all end
they
up dying after
they have another one that's coming out, like literally.
There's
a new one coming out.
Final Destination.
Went hard.
Yes.
That
fucked me up. Like, it made me so anxious.
I'm 95, I'm skirt past them trucks.
You know why I like that? Because it was a different type of scary. It was almost like the
realistic
Jigsaw movie.
Yeah,
like it was like different
was
ways
worse,
of be creepy.
Because I actually still do that to this day.
You what? Think of that shit.
Think some shit gonna pop off and then be like.
Yes, and I had to pray about it because I'm like.
You think you is. Miss Cleo?
No, it don't happen, thank God. But I'm saying the movie, you know.
The movie was lit.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't never used to hook up in the movies. Y'all skipped over that part. I know y'all was getting busy in the movie theater. Look at you, look at her. That's crazy.
Oh,
what's wrong with
you?
It was like one time, but it wasn't not like. Like
I can't
whole,
tell that
like,
story
you know,
right now.
Your whole crew going or whatever. Mm-hmm. It was like one time.
I don't know. My mom might watch this. I can't tell that story.
Man, I was in the movie theaters, man.
Yeah, I know the boys. That's crazy.
Yeah, I was a freak ass boy.
Yo, I'm wild.
You were getting busy in the theater. She started stuttering.
I was in high school. Mm-hmm. I got finessed into my first time ever doing something for somebody.
That doesn't sound good.
I mean, I made a choice, but I was, you know, it's my first time.
It was like peer pressure.
From the person, maybe.
I'm trying to tell you, I can't.
Hey, Yeah. Nah, so the movie that used to definitely happen for like the guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like a dude.
But it wasn't like sex or nothing.
Yeah, no, it wasn't. Definitely was not sex.
I don't know. If you fucking in the movies, movie, that's crazy.
How do you do that?
I would treat the movies like a temp check. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'll see where she's at. Mm-hmm. So I know what
temp
can
check.
Yeah, like, so I know,
how
like,
far can I go? Are you with it type thing?
Yeah, like, so I'm not going to go crazy
you
in the movie
like,
there.
What you
yeah,
do?
Like, no, just like,
so you ain't never, like, be with the homies and then, like, you know, because the guys go and then the girls go and y'all sit apart and y'all do the other thing. And then your homies be like, yo, so what happened? And I ain't going to lie. I used to hit the homies and be like this.
Ew!
Y'all,
ew!
I'd be like, let me see.
That's so gross. I got a son. This shit is nasty.
Y'all men's is
yeah,
crazy.
Yeah, yeah, we different. Put that on them right there.
Ew.
You know what I mean? Or even as a guy,
and
you go,
they say
you
after
go
you
get that,
that
test.
You be like, slutty.
And you be like,
what they say after
like,
that?
Like, no scent. You be like, oh, it's go time, guys.
Yo,
or they just be like, he ain't lying.
Yeah.
This shit is...
But that's how it used to be.
Yep.
But now the movie theater, they serving 4-3-course meals in there.
I like that.
Drinks,
I love
the
waiters.
Yeah, the
waiters.
You hit a button, they coming up to check on you. I'm like, ladies, stop coming over here. I snuck in my candy. I snuck my goodies and my
they
treats.
They don't care.
I'm still sneaking my
whole
treats in.
Meals. I
but now,
whole meals.
I had a girl with a big purse and she used to sneak the wine bottle in.
Yeah,
yeah
like
wine
that too.
Or water in here.
But now there's like, they have even like surge prices at movie theaters. Like, certain movie theaters, like if it's like 9 o'clock and it's booked, they charge more for that time.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
What's the last movie you've seen?
That's what
I
was trying to think.
In a theaters in a while.
When the last time you've been to movies?
Oh, actually, we just went to go see...
Bob Marley?
No. I heard that wasn't...
Yeah, I heard it was not good. I didn't
go see it. What did we go see?
That's disappointing. I wanted to see that.
Damn, we went to go see something. I can't remember.
What's the one that's called...
Maybe Creed 3?
I ain't
that's
seen two.
A long time ago. No, the Mockingbird.
There was another one.
That came out on Netflix.
No. Hunger Games.
Hunger.
I went to see
Hunger
Games.
I didn't see
that. Was the last time I went to the movies.
That's old, yeah.
No, there's a new one that came
out.
Oh,
it's a new Hunger
that
Games?
Came out
oh,
like,
I went to go see
like
Beyonce's
December.
Concert for show.
At the movie theater?
In the movie theater?
Because
yeah,
I missed it.
I saw
it.
Taylor Swift recently.
At the movie theater?
I fuck with you.
I was like, she got no, one?
No, right
she got one at the movie theater?
No, because I missed the concert. I had to go.
Oh, all right. I ain't go see it. I felt like I seen the Beyonce when she did Coachella. I'm like, yo, I seen this.
And I love the Coachella one.
It's
the
better.
Coachella.
It's better at Coachella. I know it wasn't your
it was
in your little movie theater
getting...
experience. Your little surround sound.
It was good. That's all I got to do. It was good.
Yeah, I saw Hunger Games. That's my shit right there.
So. Yeah, I was sneaking in my Twizzlers. I was sneaking in some Sour Patch Kids and
Chipotle burrito.
Damn,
a whole burrito.
You open that shit.
That's
everybody
smart.
Gonna smell that. Everybody gonna smell that. Though you open that up,
so
they be like, they don't serve that up front. Somebody lying, like she snuck that in.
So
she said,
not
so
not
what?
Checking nobody purses.
I asked, like, hey, I seen a motherfucker bring a whole Taco Bell in that bitch. One
no,
time.
That's
I said,
crazy.
Crazy.
I'm not surprised.
Whole box, a whole Taco Bell box. I'm like, damn.
Yo, that's crazy.
All right, let's take a little turn. You know, that was like we were over here. We were over there, and we were about to go, like, on the ramp. What's the weirdest moment during sex? Most awkward or weirdest moment you ever had during sex?
I can't tell this
story. She's laughing and shit. She leaned back. She didn't spent in the chair. She spent.
Honestly, I really don't have a weird or awkward moment. I literally have not ever
I'm saying nothing someone else has done or woo-woo. How you not having a weird? You ain't pushing the envelope then.
No.
You're not really pushing.
You had to have a weird moment in your whole entire life.
She lying,
no,
bro.
I promise you, I literally cannot think of a weird moment.
Awkward? Weird?
I think awkward and weird is kind of in this tune.
That's what I'm saying. So you ain't had no awkward?
No.
I'm going to tell mine, but not who.
Oh, I ain't asked for less.
I think I know. No, but I haven't. Literally.
Yeah, you do know. This was the weirdest shit that ever happened to me, actually.
Damn. This is the weirdest shit that ever happened to me, actually. So
come
buckle
to think
up.
About it.
She ain't had to think about that shit. She's still like
hold
mad. She's upset
horses.
About it still a little bit.
Hold your horses.
I don't know if it's just weird to me, us, because she thought it was weird as fuck, too. I told her.
I thought it was something else.
Yeah, I do, too. I still think. Anyhow, so... boom, 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 years ago, whatever, whatever.
I like how you put that on everything.
Boom, boom, boom.
It's the truth.
No, the years ago. Oh, she was on that. She'd be like, let me date this shit up.
It's the truth. Currently, you know, I'm in a happy relationship. You know, I'm a mother. I don't do shit.
I'm a mother.
Anyways, yeah, some years ago, you know, after going out, having a good time, this person I had known for years, whatever the case was, we ended up hooking up. And everything was going pretty great.
Oh, so it was something because it was consistent?
No, no, no. It was a one-time
thing. Oh, it was doing pretty great, like, during the hookup?
Right.
Okay.
Everything was straight. And then out of nowhere, in the middle of the hookup, he asked me to smack his ass.
Oh shit! I didn't say that.
I'm saying, how? What? In what position would you be able to smack it? Was a missionary? You would have to reach back and smack it ass. I'm trying to figure out how an ass smack would take place with him.
Yeah.
Cause now she got to. She got cause women don't be as big as men, so you gotta smack that.
Yo.
Cause I've had like a girl try to like grab my ass. Like I'm like, yo.
But you never ask no girl to smack your ass.
Listen.
In those words.
Smack that shit one time.
Yeah, how do you ask that shit?
She'll be like, what?
I think that's how it went.
Yo, just give it like
one time for the one time.
Smack it. Like, maybe like grabbing it. All right, that's normal.
How did he ask? Can you give me the breakdown on how he asked?
Was it missionary? What like what position?
Yeah. Yeah. He was on top.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, smack my ass.
Yo, ass.
And he says, smack my ass.
Yo, somebody asking you to smack ass like in a missionary position? But, no, that's nasty work.
But listen,
that's crazy.
But listen, I was so stunned that.
I was so stunned that
my reaction was to do it. Like,
how many times you smacked his ass?
Just once, and I was very appalled. I was very appalled. I was just like, it was it for me at that moment. It was just like,
okay, let's wrap it up.
Because I've been with girls before, and I just, in that moment, I felt like, oh shit, I'm not, no, I haven't been with girls. I don't, what if my mom sees this?
That's all right.
After you smacked it, though, was he like,
you smacking ass, harder. Shit. You smacking ass, girl. You didn't smack some ass. Yo. You got the juice now.
Nah, that's crazy. That is weird.
Yeah, that's weird crazy. Though.
Yeah, and that was it for me. It never happened again. It wouldn't happen again because in my head it screamed gay, and I felt really very appalled by that.
Not that there's anything wrong with being gay.
Yeah.
If you fucking me, it is. Yes, it
weird.
Is.
That was weird.
Fuck that. If you're gay and you don't tell a woman that you're gay, that's crazy.
He might have been bottled.
If you don't tell her that, that's crazy.
Or he might not have.
You would have gave him a chance still if he was bi?
Who?
No.
What? No.
That's
no.
Crazy.
Absolutely not.
Anytime I ask some shit that's out, they be, huh? Who? What?
Absolutely.
No.
They put three commas in a sentence every time something.
What? I mean.
No.
No awkward moments. No numb.
No, I literally cannot think of none.
No. Nah. Cap, put two cap. I wish I had my blue cap. I put it right on your head.
No, that
right
ass. I really can't think
what's
of
your, what's an awkward moment? Or like some of the weirdest shit that's transpired.
I would probably say the only like awkward thing is like you probably had this happen.
Don't be putting me in on your shit. He pointed at me with a whole hand. You.
This might have happened
you
to you.
You definitely been there before.
No, like a girl ever give you head and you feel like, yo, you doing too much right now, like, but you're not doing nothing, like, at the same time.
Yeah.
Like, she's just like going crazy. And you're like, yo, chill out. You're not even doing nothing right now. You're kind of sitting there like.
Right.
Yeah. I never had like nothing like weird.
Mm-hmm. But have you told her like
just me?
I would just try to say it nice, like not. I would just be like just like come here. Forget me. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm not gonna be like yo, you trash. Like,
so if they tell you if you're doing that, ladies, and they tell you to come here, you in.
Yeah, but no, it's real. Right. I feel like it's social media, and then like the whole like gawk gawk or woo, like you know what I'm saying? Like you ain't got to get in here and be going rapid fire or and that's the same thing even with sex. Like girls will get on top of you and just start
like think they're boom, a porn
boom,
star. Yeah,
boom. Like yo, hey, relax, bro. Like chill, you know what I'm saying? Like even like
some guys like for you to do a lot when you
you can, but just like
you gotta fill it out.
And that's the thing too. I feel like you got to learn your partner. You know what I mean? Because sometimes they come into the shit trying to, no pun intended, trying to do the same thing they did in the past relationship that worked for them. It's a whole new person, a whole new being. So you got to learn your
partner. I feel like even before sex gets good, it takes like a couple of times with that person too.
Yeah. Sometimes, like, sometimes you had that you can hit it off the, like off the gate. You can hit it off the gate. That's when I feel the power shifting.
I'm saying like where y'all are like comfortable with each other, like where you could even get to that point where you could like tell her what you want her to do or what she wants you to do. You know what I'm saying?
That's why I tell people, I feel like it's really best like if that communication happens beforehand. So what do you like? What are you into?
That ain't it.
That shit slap.
That was not it.
When do you do that? In the movie theater?
Maybe. I'm whispering over like, I'm a we're not supposed to be doing this type of person, guys. We could get caught.
I'm just trying to picture, like, how do you do that in a movie? Unless it's like IPIC. But then it's like, if you're an IPIC, they still checking on you every like 10 minutes.
I don't care. You check over here.
Imagine at the movie theater is crazy.
Imagine that.
That's like, that should be illegal. It's illegal.
If you're watching this.
that's crazy.
So that's how I feel about it. So you said, okay, she was doing too much. And it was awkward. Yeah.
What's your story?
Yeah, what about you?
I can't be the only one.
No, I'm saying, like, even like you said, I've had times where, like, it's hurt. Like, she thinks she's doing it hurt. And I'm like, and she thinks I'm like enjoying myself. And I'm just like, yo, you're doing damage.
Yeah.
Like, I have sensitive skin. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, please calm this shit down. Like, a little bit. Like, I'm going to leave here with wounds. We won't have the Aquaphor. Like, please. Because some people, they put them teeth, they think they're doing some shit. It's shit like, that ain't it, yo.
It's too much.
Yeah, it's too much.
So, and, do you tell them in the moment?
I like, if shit pop off I'll show them the damage. Like, look what you've done to me.
So, you will go through the pain?
I don't know. Because sometimes, you know, when guys be doing too much, like.
Yeah, y'all had a guy start nibbling and start doing some crazy. Like, whoa.
Watch out.
You gotta chill out. You gotta chill out. You gotta direct them like you're driving a stick.
Hey, be clear. This is my daddy house. Hey, be clear.
But, I don't know. I had some awkward shit happen.
Please share, because I'm not. I've had
at least two women that have really been infatuated with teeth and want to lick my teeth. Like, they're just like, I want to lick your teeth. And I'm just
lick
like, yeah, just like, smile and let me lick your fucking teeth.
And
like,
you let them?
Yeah. I'm not, it's not like a line crossing. I want to make you happy and I want you to get wherever you need to get at and I want you to get you in the mood.
Very odd.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it is very odd.
But what do you do when she's looking at your teeth? You're like,
I'm like, oh, this shit crazy. In my head? Like, oh, this shit mad crazy right now.
Me and his face was like, what?
I'm still confused.
Some women are like really into teeth, like that.
But licking the teeth, you like nice smiles. Yeah. Nasty, but licking teeth is weird. That's,
It's a bit much. I've had a.
Oh, you've had the third nipple.
I did have a third nipple. And now I think about it.
A girl I used to date,
she had a third nipple.
She had three nipples?
Yeah, it was like a little joint under the joint. Like, you know what I mean?
Don't just say that like that.
Yeah, it was a third nipple. I've actually seen like two girls that had third nipples. Like, I've seen two. And like, it's more common than people think. Uh-huh. Like, you know, so. Never I think it's kind of cool. But I'm like, I'm goofy. Like, so I licked the third nipple. Like, just to make, I don't want no stones left unturned. Like, I want everybody to be happy here. So I had a mom walking on me one time.
Oh, that's crazy.
I was at like the girl I was dating house. Sad. And I was in high school. This was like the girl that my first like girl I thought I liked, and I'm like, and she was just playing the shit out of me. She was a senior. She was one of the 19-year-old seniors. Mm-hmm. And I was a sophomore. And we was over there, and I was chilling at the mom house. We all in the room, like, chilling and vibe. Mom busting there, and we under the sheets.
Damn, at least you were covered.
We under the sheets, but her mom comes in and holds a conversation with her like I'm not there.
Did she know you were there under the sheets?
The mom knew I was there. I'm chilling. Like, I'm looking at the mother
that means she did like, that all the time.
I hope you're in here and you're doing right and you're using protection. And like, this shit was so awkward.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Like, the mother was talking, and I'm just like this. And she was giving her, like, the lecture and talking. She was like, Mom, just get out. Oh, and then she was
white.
If she was mixed, but it, she was like,
because that was my first
her
thought.
Mom, her mom was white and Jewish, and her dad was black.
Okay, because see if the daddy had white.
Yeah, the daddy wasn't in the picture. The daddy was, but you know, you ain't like you already know, like, it has to be some white in it because
it
has
to be.
There's no
you're
way
not about to be in no black household in the room.
Exactly. Yeah, there's no way I'm gonna sit there and have a conversation while I know this young man is under the blanket
naked,
with you.
Bucking
you
naked.
Better be using.
Yeah, that's
kind of wild. That is weird. So that was awkward, and then after the mom left, like, she was just wanted to get back into it, and I was like,
no,
I think it's time you take me home.
Like nothing.
Yeah, I think it's time
you take me back to
take me home
where I live.
Yo, I hate to break it to you, but that was happening on a regular for her.
Yeah, probably. That's what it
probably.
Like,
because I was crazy. So dumbfounded. We was in a relationship. Like, I went out to I went out with the homies on to like an all ages club in high school. And we used to always go to Denny's afterwards. That was like the thing. Mm. Go get you some tenders and fries or some Caesar fries or Moons or Miami. Like, you know what I mean? That's what we sliding to Denny's and doing. And she was at Denny's with another guy.
Oh, shit.
And then all the homies were looking at me like, bruh, she's cheating. I'm like, no, that's just like her friend. Like, she just at Denny's at 2 a.m. just vibing.
He was making her a playlist.
Yeah, I bet. Probably knocking her down to that bit too. So
not at Denny's at 2 a.m.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that shit happened. Yeah, it was two things. Yeah, so that's some awkward moments.
Yeah.
It's gotten awkwarder, but yeah, that's, I feel like it's a good
base.
What
is the awkwarder? You supposed to...
Is that a word? I'm creating shit out here. Awkwarder.
You're supposed to tell the most awkwardest. The look in his teeth is crazy.
He has too many stories.
That one was wild. Like, yeah, his teeth licking is crazy.
I'm so flabbergasted by that. Like, let me lick your teeth. Yeah. What?
Yeah, man. I don't know. Hey... Women like suck my toes without a heads up.
Yeah, but I know women that like to do that.
But if you don't know that as a guy, that's a throw. You threw me off just now.
I'm too ticklish.
Yeah,
I would. My feet, I'm ticklish. Yeah, I would never put a man's toes in my mouth.
Yeah, but that's disgusting.
And like,
I can massage. I can massage your feet. Your feet, but putting your toes
and like
in your
men's
mouth
feet,
is crazy.
Like, our feet is like made for just like. Stomping around, we ain't like we have gentle
just
feet.
Rough.
Yeah, I don't know. I'll take care of my shit, but it would still throw me.
Said I take care of my shit.
Let me throw that in there, ladies. Takes care of his feet.
Not to get them done now, just in case.
Yo, what's up with you? Yo,
yo, what's up with you? I'm so sorry. That was a good one.
Not you. Ready? Just to get my hand.
Just in case you want to suck on it. So,
whatever. We're going to the next subject. That was enough. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, and then,
like, it doesn't do anything.
Mine was
like
still the most awkward. I don't care. That was crazy.
It was.
That is just wild.
It was.
I would have stopped. I would have said no.
Yeah.
Get off of me.
You'd be surprised. I was stunned.
I'm going home.
Who wants to start the next one? Mm. Who wants to answer it first? Don't be peeking over there trying to check the cheat sheet. She's trying to hit the cliff notes up and shit. Just chill out.
It don't matter. I'll start.
Mike.
Oh. Yeah, Mike. Let's go, Mike.
Why didn't your last relationship work?
Oh, Lord. Is this question?
Yeah.
Oh, <that's> Lord. I think because now I got a wife and a baby.
Okay.
So, like, I've been with her for a while now.
All right.
So, the relationship before that, I think I was, to be honest, I think I was just playing too much games.
Mm. Like, okay. Accountability. You know, like, yes. I like that.
Accountability.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like, I'll be real, like, looking back at it now, I was probably just wasting that girl's time.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Because you were in a relationship, you like the idea of having this girl.
She's a placeholder.
But I wanted to hang out with, like, my boys more, you know, still live my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of drug her along for the ride.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably me, realistically.
You made her stronger.
I made her stronger.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
I helped her out. Yeah, did her a favor.
Find positive in this shit.
Yeah,
you
did
a good job.
I built
you
her.
Did a thing. I'm just joking at home. Where that was a joke, guys.
I hate the men's species.
This is how they think. This is
the
barbershop talk, guys.
For the real world.
Right? Yeah. Now get out there and be great. No, but serious shit, man. Because I have like, I have exes, or even women I've dated, and I know like, I'm not the guy for you, but I know you're gonna be great for somebody, and I still want them to do great and want them to be like the best them. And I get so upset when they make like poor decisions. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, bro, you better than that. Like, become a baby mama. I'm like, yo, come on, bro.
After dating you?
Yeah, I set you up. I got you strong.
You set the play up?
Yeah, I set this shit up, man.
The screen?
I showed you what a good time. You had a time of your life. I sent you
so
out
how
there.
You had the time. They had the time of their life, and then what happened? Why did it end?
because I knew it was no longevity for me. You know what I'm saying? That's when I come to them and I said, hey, I hit them with my infamous line. Hey, listen, we had a good run.
Yo, what?
We had a good run.
How long is your run to tell her that?
Hurtful.
Like, huh? How long
it's
is
not,
your run?
It's like, not out of a hurtful spot. Like, you know what I mean? I'm wishing you the best. Because a lot of times that shit happening if they like they want to continue or they trying to spin the block. And it's just a, hey, we had a good run. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we had a good time. I wish you the best. Interesting. It was like that. Why you smart? What's wrong with you today?
I hate the men's species.
I'm saying, like,
but like how long were you with her to just hit her with that, though? Like,
we had a good run?
Yeah, like, is it a
It's not anybody in particular. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, like, it's happened. Like, we dated. We had fun.
No,
we
he's saying, how long did you date? Before you,
that's what I'm saying. I've hit multiple people with the we had a good run.
Okay, so
that's why I ain't trying to. I don't.
What about the time span relationship that you? What was the question? Actual relationship.
The last relationship.
Yeah. What's the reason of your last breakup? Yeah.
Did you hit her with the we had a good run?
No, you didn't. Let me answer what you just answered. Like I run into an ex from college. I run into an ex from high school, and I speak. I'm cordial. I'm like, hey, how you doing? What do you? They with a group of friends, and all their friends is like, who's that? Who the hell is that? How you know him? And they be like, oh, I used to talk to him. And they be like, bitch, what happened? Like, you know what I'm saying? So, and then they'll look at me and be like, I just wish you could have acted right. Like, they give me that speech. I'm like, yo, you got to get past that. Like, we not there no more. And that's letting me know that you still kind of like have an attraction and have like some kind of picture or vision. Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean? That's me saying, hey, yo, we had a good run. Like, get past it. Move on. Move forward. Onward and upward. So I'm not coming from like a means.
Like a malice place.
Yeah. I mean, like, well, I want you to do well. I want you, like, when I see like relationships and happy homes and woodoo, I'm like, yes, good for you. Great job. Like, I'm cheering from a distance.
You better than me.
I don't want you to do bad. I don't have nobody, no exes that, like, I want you to find your person. You know what I'm saying? Because I know, like I said, you had a good time, had a time of your life, but I do have sometimes the capability or have had the capability of driving somebody crazy. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. I like when they doing bad.
That's fucking crazy.
Like,
are you a Scorpio?
I don't have anything. No, you good.
Nah, Virgo. Like, if you did, like, if I was the one in the wrong.
I like when you doing bad.
Yeah, like, don't do better than me. What's wrong with you?
What?
Like, no, I'm saying, like, if I
thought you was a nice guy.
No, but let me hold up. Let
His
me land.
Is
no,
red.
No, let me land though. Like, if I'm the one that did you wrong, then I'd wish you the best. But like, if you did me wrong,
I understand.
I don't want you to.
Even then, I'd be like, listen, once it's over, I don't really care what you're doing. But he answered his. He was being a player. What was
the reason why my last
relationship?
I feel like my last failed relationship. The reason why it failed was because of money and finances. Mm. And I'm being dead ass. Like.
No, that's a big thing.
Yeah, as a man, finances is really important. You know what I mean? Any man, like, if you find somebody that's down for you and y'all really care about one another, like, and you care about her, you enjoy providing. You enjoy going out and going out on a limb. Mm-hmm. And I feel like even I went through a struggle time where I couldn't do that. And the relationship kind of dwindled from that. Not saying she was just after me, after money, but life just got harder. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so certain shit I could usually assist with, I wasn't able to assist with. So ultimately, like...
She left or you left?
It was a joint thing. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, you know what
like,
I mean?
Like, oh, you got a lot going on. I got a lot going on. This is not going to work. We need to figure our shit out type thing.
Facts. Just like that. And then and those are the strongest... Not the strongest. Those are the hardest type of breakups because nobody's upset at nobody.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, like, it's like, damn, like, we didn't really... What did we end off? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? We didn't really end on no shit like that, but it just wasn't working out and both of us were stressed. And then a lot of people don't realize finances is huge. Like, shit, if I'm going through money troubles or if I'm struggling, like, I don't want to be intimate. Like, I'm not like, I want to grind, I want to work, I want to go to the gym. Like, I'm not in a space to be loving and caring and compassionate. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm just like, I got to figure this shit out.
That's a lot of men.
Like, I got to dog him. I got to make it do what it do. So I feel like that's what happened with that relationship. And then, like I said before, ending a relationship when nobody did wrong, nobody betrayed anybody. Like,
it's hard.
A lot of people don't know how to break up from that shit like that. Like,
so what happens, is, since you said, because there is a lot of men that really do that. Like,
do what?
You're going through financial problems, you're going through all this shit, and then you're kind of not, you know, being lovey-dovey with your girl. You're kind of just like brushing her off.
Yeah.
What happens when she goes out and she tries to look for that in somebody else and she cheats?
Mm-hmm.
How would you feel?
As a man, you're going to feel, it's going to break you more than anything.
This reminds me of Insecure.
It's going to break you more than anything for the simple fact that, you know, if you're at your highest and everything's sweet and everything's going smooth, it's a phenomenal time. And you're providing and you're keeping and you're providing safety. But as a man, a lot of times we take pride in that, but we know, like, if shit hits the fan, nobody has us. Like, you know what I mean? So for you to do that in the most troublesome time when he going through the most, you stumped that nigga out. Like, you really did a number on that guy.
Mm-hmm. So what if you, because a lot of men also don't share that.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yo,
I'm down bad right now. They won't share that.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not sharing that. You say, basically, nobody got y'all.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not sharing that with your significant other and you're like, yo, babe, I'm down bad. What if she comes to you and she be like, what do you need help with?
Right.
How can I help you?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes.
Well, that's a queen.
Sometimes. Yeah. But some men are so prideful.
You got to put your pride aside.
Yeah.
But she should be able to read that. Because if I'm with somebody and I love somebody and we in a relationship, I'm going to know when you're going through something, you had a rough day or something just rubbing you the wrong way. You can sense that even it being, it's like being in a house around somebody, but you're not really around that person. Yeah.
They're not there.
It's just like a roaming person. So that's how I feel about that. But I know a lot of men have done that. Like, they've been cheated on. Like, when the struggle, or they've been going through like the most troublesome time, or like the storm.
Yeah, because that's either going to like make or break you. Like, if you get cheated on, it's going to either turn you to a monster or it's going to just like cripple you.
Right.
It's funny because some men cheat when they're down bad.
True.
And I don't get that concept.
I agree with that. I just read a video. I just watched the video, and the girl was like, I wanted my boyfriend's Instagram password because he was staying with me, he was eating my food, and he was using my car, and he wouldn't give me his Instagram password, so I broke up with him. And normally I wouldn't side with girls, but I'm like, yo, you need to run that girl your Instagram password, because like you a bum right now.
Yeah.
And if you bumming, the thing I hate worse than when somebody is bumming is a bum that think he deserves hoes.
Yeah.
Like, you need to, like, so that's crazy.
She was basically taking care of him.
Yeah.
She asked for one thing.
Right. Like, make her feel secure, bitch. You gotta run that.
I get it.
Like, so that's how I felt when I seen that. I'm like, yo, yeah, you gotta run her that situation. Before your relationship right now, what was the reason of your last breakup in a relationship that you've been in?
Well, the relationship I'm in right now has gone a very long time. So we've had our like little breakups here and there, and we had a breakup, and I kind of started dating someone else.
Y'all had a break or a break up? Y'all was broken up?
No, we was broken up.
Okay.
For a little minute.
Man, you taking deep sighs and shit?
No, because I'm just trying to think. It was a lot. It was just a lot. Like, I wasn't fully over the person I'm with now. I wasn't fully over him.
Mm-hmm.
But I tried to move on. And I started something with someone else. And, you know, then you're dealing with stuff with that person. And it's just like, well, shit, I could have stayed where I was at with the person that
you
I really...
You thought the grass was greener.
Yeah.
No, it's not even that I thought the grass was greener. But, you know, we had our ups and downs. And, you know, I just felt like we've been going this long. It's not working.
Mm-hmm.
We need our space. Sometimes you need to like take a step back and like,
reevaluate.
Yeah. And like really appreciate the person from afar. You know, I feel like on both sides from afar to really understand like if that's somebody you want to go through shit with.
That's your person.
Yeah.
So yeah. I was like, sir. I'm not dealing with that with you.
Exactly.
Yeah. We ain't even there yet. For real,
we not there yet.
I'm dealing with this shit over here.
Exactly. I'd rather. No.
We got history over here.
Exactly.
So yeah, I went back,
mm-hmm.
and you know, That's my baby daddy. All right,
congrats. There
you go. Whatever.
What happened, yeah? What you did?
I do nothing. I am a loyal queen.
That still don't mean you can't be dramatic.
Dramatic? No. I feel like I feel like he got into the relationship with me, and it was like, yo, like, this is the real deal. Like, she's a girlfriend. Like, she wants to do this for me. Like, she's supportive, da da da. And I felt like it was.
But you were dating a rapper?
No.
Oh, you know, you talking about support. I thought you were selling mixtapes. I'm posting on your.
No, I'm just joking. I'm just joking. Support, like, businesses and shit.
Yeah.
So I think it was just like, yo, like, she's an actual woman. Mm-hmm. And I'm in this nightlife, and this is just. I'm around a lot of females, and I'm fucking up here and there over little shit.
Especially in South Florida.
Yeah, exactly. Ugh. So that's just what it was. Like, it was just like, I got into this relationship because I really love you, I like you, and this is what I wanted. But now I'm in this nightlife, and it's like, damn, I have a girlfriend over here, and she's like top tier, because I am top tier. She's top tier, and then that's like, I'm around a bunch of females and, you know, temptation, and I don't know how to handle it because I've never dealt with this before. Mm-hmm. So that it just didn't work.
That nightlife relationship stuff is hard.
Mm-hmm. Hell yeah. It's hard. I would never date anyone.
It's hard.
Nah, I can't say that. I would never again date anyone in the nightlife. Yeah. Like, all that shit. Yeah, bartending, bottle girl, dancers. They're not, because... People are like, oh, you got to have tough skin to date someone. Nah, like, sometimes that shit don't even align with your morals.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Oh, shit they got going on. Like, yeah. So they try to make it about you. Like, you know, if you really want to date me, you got to have tough skin. Like, no, a lot of them wouldn't even deal with the shit they doing.
Yeah.
And I used to try to make it a priority to be at every event. Every night.
I was on the scene queen.
Yeah, that was me.
She was on the scene queen.
I was there every night. I was there every night. But
you don't have no reason to fuck up.
Now, after a while, it's just like,
yeah, you just.
I don't.
It's like,
I'm giving too much. I'm not trying to be here. Because
then you get mad at the little shit.
It's not even that. It's that. And then when you deal with someone in nightlife, like, it's everything that comes with it.
Right.
It's them sharing stories about what other people are doing, and you're around these people, and you ain't never did none of this shit. You crazy shit you sharing with me.
And then it's like, who you surround yourself with. You're around men that are married, that are this, that, and third, and they're doing that.
Yeah.
And I've witnessed them doing that. So what are you doing? Like, no.
Yeah, sir.
No, you see
that shit.
It ain't okay.
That shit, it's a toxic environment, and especially for the money. Especially, and a lot of y'all don't realize this at home. Living in these big cities, Houston, DC, Atlanta, LA, Miami, like, these girls can take home the buku bucks and money is flash, and they're around top tier millionaire guys, especially in Miami, athletes, celebs, especially in these clubs. It's just regular, and all it takes is one night for it to be overimpressed or the right thing, or y'all going through a little argument or going through a little spell, and vice versa. Y'all going through a little something, and then that one girl sit on his lap or stroke his ego the right way.
Yeah.
Shit can happen in the car before you come home.
Exactly.
Like, you know what I mean? It happens anywhere, and then boom.
You have to be so strong. And don't get me wrong, there are people that work in the nightlife that, you know, don't play no game.
It's a few.
I have a wife.
It's a few, you know.
I have
but
a
you
wife.
Know more that, that get down with the get down.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
I feel like it also is a part of, like, the perception of being in that, you know.
The industry.
Yeah.
Like, you have, you're like,
it's like, you have to be easygoing. You have to be kind of flirty.
Friendly.
You got to do this, you got to do that.
Oh,
and it's like,
I got you. I'm going to give y'all a shot. Da, 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 da. You know what I'm saying?
I get it all the time. Even creating, like, we create the podcast, we chop it up. We shot our podcast, we have a good time. Or, you know, people like, oh, you was kind of close with such and such. I'm like, God damn. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and that's been happening since the beginning of the days, like, doing skits. They be like, even like the Jits will comment, oh, I know you knocked them ankles loose after you shot this video. No, I edited this shit.
Yeah.
Like, I scored it, I put music on it, I shot it to y'all, I promoted it, I created a clip. And, you know, even working with some women, like, for the first time, they've been like, sometimes people linger behind. They'd be like, oh, I want to watch you edit. Nah, you got it. It's time for you to go.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
pack
like,
it up, shorty.
Yeah, yeah. So, but they ain't used to that either. Like, so that has popped off, but you're right.
I can't say it has been me being, like, in the entertainment business and so on and so forth, and her too. Like, working with me doing photo shoots and stuff, like working with photographers. Oh, Lord.
Some of the photographers are not. They be trying.
Shoot, but then after you be like saying, like, you'll put a heart on a story. And I be like, yo, bro, like, it's not like that. Like, we just shot together, you feel me? So a lot of women, like,
but some photographers got down, so now they once they have one or two times, they think like it's possible.
Yeah.
I'm jaded, man. I done seen too much. Yeah. I done been around too much.
When you're so professional, women gonna be like, dang, he's really professional. I really like, yo, let me see you. And he like, nah, you gotta go. I'm shooting something else.
I can't work like that anyway.
Like, yeah, it was something like right there, like that.
I need you, you know what I'm saying? So nightlife is a different animal. And it's in itself, because you see so much, you hear so much, and then like as even like you see the like for men, it's not really about status, like, you know what I mean, but it's the access, the fact that man has so much access to just the different women, and they drinking and they're there.
Don't ever, I don't want you to ever allow another woman to know something that you did that I don't know.
Ooh, I always say that.
Don't ever.
You're not about laughing, my lady. We laughing at the whole. We, you're not about laughing at us.
Like, you let Shorty get one up on me because she saw you do whoop-de-woop. You didn't tell. Nah.
Yeah.
It's the same for, like, men. Like, our egos, super fragile. Mm-hmm. So, like, if we go somewhere and you didn't tell me that this dude that you just hugged or whatever just bumped into that, maybe you smashed in the past before. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You had me dap this nigga. Hey, you had me dap, buddy.
It's the same thing.
I'm a feeling,
Oh!
Now you have me looking stupid.
You looking like that. What's wrong with that?
No. I think it's the same
thing. Bro, I am done. I'm like, because I've been like, it happened to me before.
But I want to know. No, but because he said that, I want to know. So if you're out with your girl, you expect hopefully it's not that many, but I'm saying you expect if she runs into, or even if he's in the same, you know, area, whatever vicinity as you guys, you expect her to let you know, like, hey, 10 years ago, I've smashed him.
So it's like, it's tricky because, like, I'm cool with, like, I don't expect you to be like, act like you never met him or know him. Like, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, let's say he's talking to you and you guys are chopping it up for like a minute. You know, I know a minute ain't the longest, but that's still like enough.
It seemed like long. Listen, when you were like,
listen, I'm just kind of saying it like just to show how fragile our egos are. So his boys are like in the corner, right?
Yeah.
And he, in my head, if I think that happened, when he goes to his boys, now I'm thinking he's like, yeah, you see Shorty over there in the corner?
Yeah.
I used to knock her down. Yeah. You see how I was doing her right in front
of
her.
So my question is, would you rather, okay, so say y'all go to an event and she sees a guy that she used to date, and would you rather her, as soon as you walk into the event, say, hey, I seen somebody I used to date, he might come over here and say hi to me? Or would you want her to tell you after he already came over and spoke to her?
Prior would be better.
Prior
would be better.
Man, you know the answer to that.
I'm not saying it's like, I'm not about to walk into the van and be like, yo.
And I'm not even.
I'm going to pull you. I'm like, hey, are you talking to her?
Oh, okay. Right.
And I'm not even saying it like it's her fault. I'm just saying more or less that's how we're thinking.
Yeah,
like,
because sometimes women and men, that other person will come over just to speak, just to be spiteful, be on some corny shit like, oh, like, you know what I mean? Like, why are you coming over here? Like, if I was out here dolo, you wouldn't come speak to me.
Exactly.
But now I'm with somebody, you won't come be in my face.
People be petty. People
hey, so that's corny. I don't like that. I be looking at them, I look from a distance, like, hey,
I'm different. Come over here. I'm different. I could already tell. Oh, yeah. The way she hugged you, oh, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. You fuck with her? Exactly.
But at the same time, I'm not giving that big a hug. I'm dabbing that bit up.
Now when he's with his boys, he might be like, bro, I can still
see my
that.
Thing
you
is
see how she, and you're like, it's like,
if it's a situation like that where I see y'all dab each other up and I'm like, oh, okay, I gotta let him know because he probably don't know, you know, that's somebody from my past or whatever.
Bruh.
But if it's like he's just there and there's no like there's no interaction or nothing, it's like a wave or whatever, I'm not finna
down
your night just because of that. But if
I had
was
a situation
like that,
I ran into I was talking to the girl who was dating, and I seen like past posts, like a dude was in a post but in a group setting, you know what I'm saying? And I was like, and I seen him, you know what I'm saying? I was like, oh, what's up, bro? You know what I'm saying? I rock with your work. It's a celeb vibe. You know what I'm saying? I rock with your work. Woo-woo. Let's look it up real quick. Boom. So I sent the picture to her like, yo, look who I just ran into.
That's That's petty.
No, no, I didn't know that they had a pass.
I was like, what?
That's what hurt. I'm like, yo, I ain't know they had a pass.
That hurt you.
And then she text you back like.
I ain't know they had a pass. And then I sent the picture, right? And then she was like, like played it off. And then down the line, I found out they had a pass. So I'm like, yo, you let me take a picture with
you? She didn't tell you?
You let me take a picture with dude?
Oh, nah, she dead wrong.
Send you a picture.
The picture was already done. Nothing. The picture was already done.
The damage was done already. Why would I make it worse? Yo, that shit.
So would you have rather her tell you right as soon as you sent the picture or no? Because
Not as soon as I sent the picture because we wasn't together, but when I saw her. Like, hey, yo, let me tell you something about this.
Because
I'm thinking, like, woo-dee-woo, like, because even if, like, I could have been on some other shit, like, yo, you know my girl. You know my girl. I could have been like, yo, you know my girl. And he'd be like, oh, who? And I'd drop a name and he'd be like,
yeah, I know her.
Oh, okay. Yeah, well, I definitely know her. Like, it could have been worse. Like,
so
you know what I mean?
Does it hurt more if it's like a somebody of a high status?
Like an athlete or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like for a man, it's always going to hurt more because guys are cheat or guys that do stuff or guys do ringy stuff and it'll just be like a one-off or nothing that means anything. But a lot of times when women do it, it's a upper class guy or something mm-hmm. like that. And a lot
somebody
of times...
Somebody better, they upgrade.
It's an upgrade and or even like in a better social status. Mm-hmm. But a lot of times it'll hurt too, guys. Like, even if like some shit pop off, and you step out or woo-doo-woo, like, let it be somebody that really cares about you, likes you, or sees potential or a relationship in you.
What if it's not a step out, though? But, what if it was before you?
I feel like if it's before me, just let me know what's up. Like, mm-hmm. don't have me sending you, like, Bubba with a fool. But if it's a step out or something happened like that, the worst thing that happened with a guy is you step out. And the dude she step out with is treating your girl like one of the hoes.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Like, damn. Like, yo, I love you. Like, and he treating like you is, you was just one of them ones. Like, you a throwaway. Yeah. You like, I'm in your city. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn. Like, you know, that's your queen, but not to him.
Not him.
That's just a, and we all know, like, the little, like, jump offs. But to him, your queen is his jump off.
Yeah.
That's tough.
And, like, as men, we're like, whether it's right or wrong, we're like hyper competitive.
Yeah.
So, like, If let's say the dude that you're talking about is like The Rock, girl, I can't do nothing with you.
I can't compete.
Like,
hey, The Rock pulling in 30, 40 mil a year. Like, what am I gonna do with that? What am I gonna do? Let's be realistic.
Like,
yeah,
if it's like Jimmy Butler,
I can't do nothing with you.
He said, girl, I can't do that.
Like Jimmy Butler, like he just dropped 30 last night. Yeah. Like, I can't do shit.
Well, maybe she wants a regular guy.
I'm gonna tell her, hey, go off, go do you, man.
Yeah. Yo, go get him.
Go do you, man. Go do you.
You know what? Go ahead.
Now I'm telling my homeboys, yo, you know my ex.
She's the date The Rock.
Yo.
What are we supposed to do with that?
That's funny.
That did ass. She talking about that's Lens funny sips. Yo, you
Lens is crazy.
That's funny.
That's funny. the sip and look away.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah, so and that's I feel like that's the different day and age that we're in. When our parents and our grandparents were dating and they were out here, they only had access to what was in the city. If they wanted to meet a celeb, they had to go to the show and scream,
Yeah,
I like you. Like they had the concerts type vibe. Now, if you can hop in a DM and people be like, oh, he's not gonna reply, bro. These dudes be bored and horny. Like Drake be replying to the most regular looking, and they be screenshotting. So they're there. They're
hopping
checking
the
DMs.
DM
so
crazy.
You got access, like you know what I mean, and it's instant access. So it's just a different day. So you just never. You never know if you want that type of attention. I'd say that's why I tell guys like, if you ready to settle down, you ready to chill, you gotta find you one that got a LinkedIn and not a Linktree. Like, you know, it's a different, but you gotta get you a little.
Wow, this is shady.
We got Linktree, but it ain't exactly. OnlyFans.
That's an OF on
this
that.
This is shady.
It ain't OnlyFans.
This is shady. This is very, very shady. You cannot control.
I've been in a relationship before where he wanted to do OnlyFans together, but I didn't do it.
But the thing is, like,
that shit up there forever. It's gonna be a backfire. You know what I mean?
That's what I felt.
So
like,
are you saying that, like,
hold up, you would rather my words up right now.
You would rather date someone who hasn't dated like men of this caliber or celebrity?
Yeah, I don't get that.
No, I would rather seriously date someone who's like
not on the internet and heavy on social media.
Like a nun.
No.
Because you're on social media.
But that's because you are.
I know, but that's just, I'm just telling you what I would prefer. I wouldn't want somebody that's like.
So you're not going to date somebody that's doing the same thing as you, basically?
Nah, I'm good.
And that's okay.
Like if
it's not
go,
he knows. Yeah. He like knows.
If you go and you see her, if she tells you her Instagram and she's got like 700 followers, oh my God.
Yeah.
She's fire.
Hey, 700, no, you know what make it fire? 700 followers and no mutual friends.
No mutual friends. I'm melting.
Yeah. I'm in the chair like, oh, she's the one. We have no mutuals. Because you know when the mutuals kick in the gear, you're like, God damn.
She might have dated him.
She knows such and such. I know this guy is an animal.
Yeah, the mutuals like, is crazy. The mutuals is nuts, man.
It's
crazy.
Well.
Yeah. So I just would, I like, and even on like on dates and hanging out, when women are too into their phone, like I hate that. I'm like, yo, put your phone. Can we leave phones in the car? Like, you know, I don't like that.
In the car is crazy.
And some
people, not in the car, but put your phone down.
You go on a date. I'm like, yo, can you put your phone up? You know, I'm a content creator. Then I'm like,
oh wow, that's dang. Crazy.
On my dime.
You recording this? You better get me in.
It really is starting to get a little.
It's getting a little nuts, man.
Yeah.
Don't touch your food. Yeah, no, I want to take like a boomerang like of it. I'm like, oh, this is getting out of hand.
See, even when we do like birthday dinners and stuff, I always tell her, when you walk in, take your pictures first. Before, let's do that first before the food come out. Let's
you
get over.
You a good friend with that though. You be like, you do the picture thing, and y'all be making sure everybody,
you know,
everybody get their no, joint take care.
Girl, because like we about to eat and stuff, like nobody.
We
got,
about to eat
and
stuff.
Then after you eat, you get a little bloated, so you know. Let's do it before the food come. You know.
All right. So so you really ain't answered the question.
Me.
Yeah, I said me. I said
yes, I did.
I said why didn't
I
last?
Like the whole nightlife shit. I wasn't.
Yeah, she
you went for it.
Yeah.
Okay,
no,
chill out. You got her back. We know. She answered that shit. Now move on. Would you let your significant other go to their ex's funeral?
Ooh, I'm gonna say yes because I would.
You would go to your ex's funeral?
Yes. I'm cool.
If you were in a relationship, like happy relationship? If you were married, would you go to your ex's funeral?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm cool with
the family and all that shit.
Yeah, I'm cool with all my exes pretty much.
I,
and it's like no fun.
He scooted away.
All my exes? You lost me. I was with you with Nightlife, buddy. But I'm cool with all my exes, pretty much.
It's really not that many. Relax.
Hey, yo. You gotta like, that's a red flag. Cool with all your exes and shit.
I am. Like
my exes from high school, like, sure, we're cool, but not we don't talk like we're not friends. Like, but hey,
you follow my Instagram
from high school?
No.
Yeah, you do. You looking up in the air and shit? Yeah.
I think I do.
You do?
I think right. I do.
No, I recently,
you don't follow no exes.
No, I do. I follow.
But recently, but one ex. Like, you know, we both having kids and shit. Like,
okay, you grown? Like, oh, okay.
Yeah, it's been years.
Yeah, I feel you. That's different, like high school type shit. But you follow your exes?
My last relationship
on Instagram.
Yeah, yeah. Cause I'm not the type like just to be like, oh, unfollow you, block. You know what I mean?
I
like,
feel
the
like,
last relationship that we was talking about. No,
I feel like
follow.
If your significant other got caught cheating with that ex,
yeah, then
still
texting
that ex or doing funny business with that ex, it's an absolute
if it's an ex that crosses
different.
The line,
it's a no.
That's different.
But if it's like y'all still cool or whatever, y'all. Whatever.
But sometimes, like, your ex might like a kid, like a pick of your baby. You might like a pick of her and her family. Like, that's cool. You know what I'm saying? As long as it ain't crossing the lines.
Would you be cool if your wife went to her ex's funeral?
Hell no.
What you just said?
Nah, because that's crazy.
Hey, I knew that man caught him right off of that shit.
Nah, because, like, is the casket open? Because that's even crazy.
Yeah.
What?
Like, you going to go see him?
Right. You had to get that one last time. One last time, huh?
No, like, this man is crazy.
Like, what if she's like, oh, you know, it's so crazy. I was just with him the other day.
Yo, what?
Then that's another
thing. Hey, what if she says? She says like a speech. Like, she's like, you know, people talk.
Yeah,
get it
back when we were together.
What if she posts like on her stories? Like, all I was just pictures. Talking to you. Like, like old text.
Or
like,
old
you know
pictures.
How people do that?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
Like,
If the text messages ain't in them old school Instagram bubbles, you know how the old school text messages and DMs used to look?
Yeah, yeah.
If it look new, I'm mad, yeah. If it, any of the updates, I ain't with it. How you feeling if he goes to the ex funeral?
I would go with him.
I ain't say you could go to. That wasn't part of the shit. She included herself. I think he could go and we could go together.
Yeah.
We could do it.
We could go together as a couple, as family.
That's crazy. You gonna meet that man family?
What you mean?
I'm saying the ex is...
If my ex wants to go to his ex funeral...
Right. Oh, so you gonna meet that lady family?
Yeah, I'm gonna go. Hey, what's up? Sorry for your loss.
Go hey, she gonna go up there and look at the casket. Thank you for passing the torch.
Yeah. I don't play what? With deaths like that, mm-hmm. though. Like, it, you know, the one thing is, like, because it's the ex that died, I would respect them. You know, they're not here anymore. It's like,
I think it just depends.
But I would.
Hey, you really out the picture, huh?
No, I think it depends. It depends on the relationship. Like,
but it's been a situation where the person I was with, there was a death that happened, and the ex wanted to come to one of his family members.
Yeah.
And I said, no, I'm not okay with that.
Damn. Why you wasn't okay with that?
Because why? I'm here now. Like, why?
Yeah, I know they might want to pay their respects.
Yeah, I understand. But like, if it was cordial, cool. But if we're not cordial, I feel like that's
If y'all ain't cordial, I feel.
You know?
If y'all not cordial, I totally understand that.
Yeah, so if it was cordial, I probably would have felt a different way about it. But since it wasn't cordial, no. But if it was actually the person, I would have to be an adult about that. Like, damn, this person passed. That's somebody that meant something to you. Even if it
that's
was
what
a
said.
Friendship
it depends on, like,
or whatever.
The relationship and the history.
You know? I feel like... in a different situation where it's somebody else, you could just send a text, sorry for your loss. Yeah. You don't have to be present.
Right.
You know, if it's not all cool. But yeah.
I wouldn't mind it.
If it's your ex that you was trying to cheat and text and call and no, you can't go. Absolutely not. No. No.
Why you wanna see that bitch?
See, what if it's your ex, right?
You deep on it. Go ahead.
What if she's like OD crying?
Mm-hmm.
Like she's just over.
Oh,
crying.
Sobbing over the shit.
Yeah,
like
crazy.
But
crying.
Yeah, that's a little. That's a little
you're
like.
You're not gonna be like, damn, like.
Right.
A few
you
years
really
care for
this man.
People die every day.
Yeah.
Oh
no. Nah, it depends.
Y'all heartless.
Nah.
No, because the person I had lost my virginity into and everything, like my first high school love, he passed away, and when I went, that shit hit me.
Yeah.
It was like, damn.
But that's
like,
also probably like
really
your first
died.
Death. That's probably your first, like.
No.
It wasn't?
Mm-mm. It was just.
I thought about this, but no, it wasn't.
Okay. No, not the first death I experienced. No. I lost my grandpa at like 12. That was hard. So.
No, like, I feel like it depends on relationship because.
Yeah, maybe. I wouldn't mind if she went over it for real.
What's crazy is when.
Look at the finger.
Because this has happened to people that I know. What's crazy is, like, God forbid, if your person passes and see, yeah, now I gotta rethink things because if your person passed,
all the exes come, and they doing the most,
and they crying and doing the most, trying to outcry you and do all that shit.
Exactly.
Give me
all
Tyler Perry
the bitches showing
and
up.
You better show up and fall out.
They posted all the
old
videos.
Posted all the shit.
All the old videos from Snapchat.
I don't like
that's
that.
The worst when the celebs be dying, when the celebs, something happened to the celebs, and all of the side chicks be like, I was just supposed to see you Tuesday.
Posting the whole thread. Posting the whole thread.
Yeah,
you know that man got a wife. That's crazy.
What are you doing? I'd be so disappointed. Like, y'all couldn't wait.
That's disrespectful to me. That's like respect.
I'm going to my ex funeral, were you with it or not. My ex, I grew up with. So I'm going.
Yeah, but
regardless.
You probably won't do it the most.
You ain't going.
Yeah.
Going
some
to
girls do the most.
I'm going.
You think you're going?
You're going to go into casting with
her? Nah, you know.
All of a sudden, we just go on a trip.
I would
on a
genuinely
road.
Be
saying,
don't do the most. Don't do the most.
Why are we passing? Poor St. Lucie? We're going to just relax, put your seatbelt on, take a nap. Yeah.
Dang, I went to high school in Port St. Lucie. That's crazy.
There ain't shit going on up in PSL.
It's not.
All right, last but not least, what's the last subject that you failed? Whether it's high school, college, what's the last subject you got to have? Go ahead. We're going to let her go first because we went over the subjects. Go ahead. She hyped. She's so hyped. Go ahead, man.
I didn't fail anything. I graduated 3.9 GPA.
3.9 GPA didn't fail anything.
I was on an honor roll.
Magna cum laude.
I'm just smart. I'm sorry, y'all. Sorry.
Good job. All your little accolades.
the last, I never got an F, but I got a D in geometry.
Okay.
I think my sophomore year of high school, I had to retake it.
Okay. You had a tough time?
Math is hard. Don't get me wrong. Math is hard.
I didn't fuck with it.
Okay.
Still don't.
That's where
I mean, we don't even use it daily.
What math smacked you up?
Like when it got crazy.
They had the triple base.
They had the square root. You know,
like they started putting shit in like parentheses. Yeah. Like, that's when I was like, oh.
The crazy thing is, the reason I never went back to college was because
geometry.
No.
Trauma.
I was doing good in all my classes. And I got to, I forgot, it was like the second semester. And I had this crazy algebra teacher.
Oh, yeah. Don't get me wrong. I drop a motherfucker quick.
I just didn't. No, yeah. So I'm trying to figure out like, damn, I know I'm going to fail this class. I don't want to fail this class. I'm at this point, I had like all B's at the time, I think. And I go to the counselor, everything. I'm like, what should I do? I don't want to fail this class.
Yeah.
The counselor told me withdraw from the class.
Mm-hmm. Were you a full-time student? You had 15 or 12. Would the withdrawal make you not a full-time student?
Right. So the withdrawal.
That tell you up.
The withdrawal made me lose my financial aid. So
that tell you
when
up,
I tried to reapply, they like, I owe all this money. And I'm like.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So that's why even as an athlete, they always made us take 15 credits just to give us leeway. Okay, we had to drop one of them.
I dropped the class real quick. I walked into that class the way that professor was teaching. And they said, oh, you do it this way. So I'm doing it my way. I get the right answer. And they're like, no, you have to do it my way. I said, bitch, I'm dropping you. Bye.
The thing about in college, I hate it with the math classes. Like a lot of times the teachers and professors were like foreign. So they didn't speak the best English. Yeah. So you're teaching some hard shit and you're not speaking the best English.
I can't understand what you're saying.
You hit me with a double whammy right now, man.
I'm like, yo.
So with that being said, I definitely felt I was dropping classes.
I still had a 3.0 and everything, and I just never went back.
What did you? I failed statistics twice. I failed statistics twice, and I had to take it at the community college that third time. I'm like,
yo, what?
And I knew I was going to fail it the third time, but I did not miss an office hour. I was in that lady's face like, you gonna see me again?
Yeah,
get me up out of here. So I had to do it like that.
One time I was in speech class, and we, you know, them group projects. Fuck out of here.
Hey, yo, my man. Yo,
yeah. Yo, what?
I knew you was going to say some dumb shit.
Everybody's in Florida know what Esau on right now.
Yeah, it is. That's special ed ass class.
Nah, they just got to get their lingo.
Man, sometimes they not special. They just can't
speak
English.
They got to get the lingo. Yeah, they got to get the lingo on.
Dang,
that's one time you was in special ed, special needs class.
I was never.
That what you just said. Is that what you just said?
No, stop playing with my friends.
Bro, well, I said speech.
Oh, okay.
Speech class.
Okay.
Damn.
Yo, he said,
and you know, you have those group projects and shit, right? So you have a group project, you know, you got to cite every fucking thing.
One person didn't cite
one fucking thing. And the lady said, oh, you lose all the points. Y'all got to redo it. I said, oh, nah, fuck you. I'm withdrawing this class. Yeah. Like, that's crazy. It was great. It was a great speech project. It was great.
Filled with plagiarism.
One little slight.
I'm letting y'all know right now, but if I had that chat GPT.
Listen here.
Y'all would be in trouble, boy.
That's crazy. I be asking it a lot of things.
Imagine. I reply to text messages with that shit. I'm like, yo, help me say this better. Copy paste. I'm like, oh, I'm on her ass with this one.
That's crazy.
I'm on her ass.
You're toxic.
Yo.
I just want my shit to come across clear.
You're toxic.
And punctual.
Imagine that in college.
That chat be GPT.
Yeah, no, that thing is crazy.
I definitely cheated on my finals.
It did my resume.
I definitely cheated on my finals.
I'm like, oh, that's tough. You cheated on your final.
I cheated.
Yeah, this going to come out.
Damn, I'm at 3.9.
I'm paranoid. Like, this going to come out. People going to see this.
Because the teacher, you know what they do? They try to leave the classroom real quick, take a little step out. Here goes phone.
Nah, I had a criminal justice teacher that used to make us get up and slide our desks forward. So we were like 3 feet away, and he was standing back of the classroom. So you could never see where he was looking. So all of our shit was forward.
And he'd been
like,
doing that shit.
I used to be
years.
So pissed. I'm not moving no desk. Like, I'm a student. Like, nobody paid me to move a desk. I was pissed because I knew I needed it.
You was going to cheat.
Did you stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance?
In school?
Yeah.
Yeah, I stood up.
I was standing up.
I went to private school. I went to private school. You had to get your ass up.
Yeah, no, I sat down.
You had to get your ass up.
I went to a technical school. I stood and stand. I was tired, bro. I just got on the bus at 6 o'clock in the morning. You want me to stand up for this shit? I'm tired, bro.
I was an athlete. I wasn't tired. I was ready.
I was tired.
We damn, already worked man. Out before school started and shit. They already ran us through. So we chilling. Smelling outside. Homeroom.
The vibes. This is irrelevant, but I remember having PE on second period. Second period. I just got up.
Damn, what period did
you
I have?
You sprang bod on yourself.
It was like fourth. It was like fourth.
You sprang bod.
No, it wasn't that. It's just like, if I
ever played, did you ever participate? Okay.
No, I wouldn't dress out. Fuck that. Give me the C.
The only time.
You was the person that would not get an A in gym.
The only time I participate is for kickball.
I wake up and get ready for school to look cute. And then I gotta dress up and then sweat out and all that. No, I'm not doing it.
Them dudes in the gym after the class, they would just think that that axe,
that axe and that bar,
everything they just did, they lost.
They would lay the shirt down and spray the shirt before they put it on. Like
a graffiti artist just.
Oh, they were spraying that shit down. Or like you don't have a shirt and you're trying to find a shirt in the empty locker that belonged to somebody else, but you like, I gotta get these points. I gotta get these points. I wanna dress out and I wanna play whatever sport's going on that day.
It was musty.
That's crazy.
Them girls are musty too.
I wasn't musty.
That's where we're gonna wrap up the podcast. Shout out y'all Instagram where they can find y'all at, whatever you got going on.
You can follow me at Shy Angelita. That's on everything. Everything.
All right.
Worth the bullet.
Okay.
Spelled how it sounds. Worth the bullet.
Spelled how it sounds.
It's bullet spelled bullet.
And it's Shai.
Yeah.
Not no Y. And it's not Shay, it's Shy.
Well, I'm gonna stop with this attitude shit toward the podcast.
We're shy. I'm gonna cut off.
No more drinks. Oh, shit, not shy.
It's in my bio, bro.
Where can people find you at?
You can find me anywhere on at the Mike James.
All right. Yep. And you got a podcast. So
and I have
podcast?
A podcast. Name is Successful Failures. Okay. So go follow that.
Oh, I like that. Oh, that's nice. Cool.
What's it about?
It's really just kind of about like what we were just doing, just shooting the shit for like 45 minutes a week.
That's dope. Yeah.
That's what's up.
So y'all check that out. Make sure y'all subscribe. Show some love.
Yeah, me and Shai, we might come out with our own podcast. We got stuff to say.
It's a producer right here.
Don't be putting extra hats on me. My shoulders is heavy.
We don't got a name yet. Oh, yeah. We get a name.
Get a name now.
We do. We got a name.
Y'all got a live stream.
No, we got a name.
All right.
You want to know?
I would love to hear the name. No, don't say it yet, because people are going to steal it. If it ain't
facts,
already in the works,
facts,
hold
facts.
It down. We'll talk about it off camera.
All right, yeah.
All right, yeah, bet, cool. Cool with the shit, goddamn. All right, yeah, bet, cool, because I'm ready. Hey, appreciate y'all rocking with me, man. Leave a dope review wherever you're watching this. Tell a friend, tell another friend about the podcast. Show love. Leave a comment. I see you watching right now, and you still ain't hit that like button. That's crazy to me. Do better.
We're
going to catch y'all on the next one. We out of here. Thank y'all.
Bye. Peace. Bye.
Thanks for listening to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast. See you soon.
See you soon. See you soon.